Atreus, follow me.
Be right there. God. Maybe I can fly.
No, no! Gods too must stay on the path, I promise you.
Look, don't be mad, but I've seen those blades of yours before. They were under the house when I was hiding. Is that why you never let me down there? Where did they come from?
They are my burden, from a life that is behind me.
Well, they're in my life too now, and I'd like to hear that story.
Those days are dead. To relive them is needless.
How can it be needless if it's the truth?
One day, you will understand.
I'll take your word for it. Brock and Sindri.
Or the Huldra brothers. Well, who doesn't? They're quite famous, or infamous, depending on your point of view. They crafted Mjolnir, you see. Thor's hammer, the Aesir's greatest murder weapon, the bane of giant kind.
They made Thor's hammer? I didn't think they'd like the Aesir.
Oh, I should say not. But this was long ago, and they were eager to make a name for themselves. Rather overdid it with that one, methinks.
Hey, check this out.
Be safe.
Hang on. Come here. You called Brock and Sindri the Holger brother?
You! Aye.
But they're doors, aren't they?
Aye.
The Holger are sprites of the forest.
Aye.
Beautiful, seductive sprites of the forest.
So why would you call Brock and Sindri the Holger brother?
Oh, well, I now realize this would be a wholly inappropriate story for young and innocent ears.
Whatever. Amir, what else did the serpent tell you when you spoke? Kinda sounded important.
I'm sure it's nothing. He just said the boy seemed familiar to him.
Me? That's impossible.
Oh, I quite agree. Unless, perhaps, he refers to something yet to be. It is said that when Jormungandr and Thor battle at Ragnarok, their clash so violently shakes the Tree of Life that it splinters, casting the serpent backward through time, even before his own birth.
What?
That is madness.
Well, I did say not to concern yourself.
They were pretty weak.
Follow me, Atreus.
Still doing it.
better yourself!
Want to see what we can trade those for?
Find the edge, boy. Another one here.
Oh, look! It's Skull and Hati, the giant wolves who chase the sun and moon.
Quite right, my boy.
Where did they come from? How did they get up there?
Well, it's a long story, but we'll get to it.
What's happening there at the end? They eat the sun and moon? And then everybody fights?
I suppose that's one way to put it.
was next to Mother's garden this whole time. No wonder we can never get in there. So desperate to find a way into Jotunheim anyway.
He's convinced the giants hold the key to changing his fate when Ragnarok comes. They are the Aesir's oldest enemies, after all, and it's their army that's supposed to do him in the end. But more than that, he covets their gifts of prophecy. He wants to know what they know and see what they see. So much suffering could have been avoided if his insatiable curiosity was not so much stronger than his wisdom.
What do you mean?
Ah, remind me to tell you why they call him the Lord of the Hanged.
Boy.
Sir. Huh. Interesting. I may want to write that down.
Ah!
Atreus, follow me.
Be right there. So why do they call Odin the Lord of the Hang?
That refers to a modest example of Odin's thirst for knowledge. The time he spent 9 days a dead man. Aye, hung himself by the neck from Yggdrasil's branches, put his spear through his own side and bled down into the Well of Destiny. He roamed the realms of the dead and plundered the World Tree of its secrets, until I think, quite rightly, it got fed up with him and sent him back to the Land of the Living. Did I not mention he was barking mad?